is Stella. Today we're going to make taro soup. Some of you probably never heard of what taro is. It is a kind of a vegetable that mainly harvest in Asian region. Koreans usually take this as a soup in holiday season because it also emits natrium in body and prevents stomach ache from overeating. I didn't like taro soup that much because I thought it has a bland taste. However, as I grew up, I started loving the taste of taro soup. Obviously, it is a food for grown-ups. So if you're ready, let's get started. Put 300 grams of taro in a water. Make sure to put a water to make a taro submerged. And put 1 spoon of salt and simmer them in a medium heat for 15 minutes. Taro has a bitter taste, so you need to put a salt to remove any bitterness inside. Then strain them and cool them down for 20 minutes. Then peel off the skin of taro using hands. Once you boil them, it'll be easier for you to remove the skin. If you have a sensitive skin like me, don't forget to wear a glove, because taro can cause irritation in your skin. Then slice them into 3-4 pieces. If taro is small enough, then you don't have to slice them. When you do this, you better use a small knife to cut off the taro. Then you have to season the beef. I'll use a brisket to make a soup. It is a lean fat, so it is perfect for making a soup. I'm gonna put sesame oil, garlic, salt, and pepper. I'm not gonna use soy sauce at this time because soy sauce will make a soup dark and cloudy. Mix this using hand and set this for 15 minutes so that all of the ingredients will be soaked into it. Then slice the white radish. Cut them into 3 parts and slice them into thin pieces. Make a square-shaped white radish. And cut the spring onion diagonally. It doesn't really matter how you cut it, but it'll taste better when you make a right figure. Now you're ready to boil taro soup. Put a sliced white radish in 4 cups of water. Bring it to boil in a medium heat. Since white radish is hard, I put them in the first place. Then, when they start making a bubble, put a seasoned beef and let them boil for 20 more minutes. The seasoning and juice inside will make the soup more flavorful and delicious. And put a taro and spring onion inside. Also, add 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 cup of water. Boil this for 5 more minutes and turn off the heat. This is perfect for a lunch and dinner, and it is surprisingly good. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button below. Hope this recipe will make your life much easier. See you next time. Bye bye.